You guys got down in that truck right there with me, and it meant so much.
An emotional reunion for Joe Reitmeier and two of the firefighters who saved his life.
I was screaming and just crying, trying to get someone's attention, and just where my truck was, you wouldn't have been able to see me.
Reitmeier was pinned underneath his pickup truck in a remote part of Bonneville County for 48 hours last August. He had rolled down a ravine, becoming trapped with his head partially submerged in water and sharp sticks jabbing into his scalp.
When the truck landed and I went out the windshield, half my face was in mud and water and his arm was tucked up underneath me and I couldn't move it.
After 2 days, Joe's sister, Tasha, became concerned that her brother wasn't home or picking up his phone. She and some friends set off to look for him and miraculously found his truck.
Hi, this is a 911 operator.
He's in the vehicle and it's full of water.
So he's in the vehicle and it's full of water?
Yeah, we can't get to him.
Is it just him in the vehicle, or is there other people in the vehicle?
I think it's just him.
Okay, do you know this person, or did you just come up on it?
It's my brother.
It was fairly remote. I mean, it's dirt roads to get there. No cell service, no radio service.
Idaho Falls firefighters Connor Cook and Jeff Hardy were first to arrive on scene. They admit they didn't know how to free Reitmeier and had never seen anything like this.
He was asking for help, but just how he was positioned in the vehicle, it was very muffled.
Nothing was supporting the underside of the truck, and the top was lying against dirt and mud, so any sudden movement could result in disaster. The firefighters called for extrication equipment, and help from the fire department and Bonneville County Sheriff's Office arrived.
This is the most complex rescue I've seen in 20 years.
We've never trained for anything like that, either us or the fire.
For 2 hours, fighting the setting sun, rescuers worked to free Reitmeier.
I was just calling out for ropes. I was calling out for shovels, handyman jacks.
He was like, please don't leave me. Don't let me go. Don't let me die here.
Reitmeier remembers Hardy holding his hand the entire time and assuring him that things would work out. Finally, after inserting large airbags under the truck, crews slowly raised it off the injured 21-year-old.
We were able to push against the truck with the side of the bank of the creek, and it pushed it up and away from the victim. And we actually brought him through the windshield out his door.
Reitmeier was flown to Ermac, where doctors diagnosed him with a broken collarbone, serious bruising, a hurt ankle, and other injuries. But just days later, he was well enough to hold this news conference where he publicly thanked the rescue crews who saved him.
I can't give these guys enough gratitude for getting me out of there.
To see him and to talk to him and just the minor injuries that he walked with was just incredible.
Firefighters and sheriff deputies deal with life and death every day, but this is a call and a young man these responders will never forget.
The will to survive on that young man was pretty intense.
We just were like, whatever it takes, if he lives, if he dies, but whatever he takes, we're gonna get him out.
Everyone in the fire department who was a part of that rescue, from the sheriff's department to Lifelight, they all do this job because they want to do the job.
In Bonneville County, Nate Eaton, EastIdahoNews.com.